What's up, Warriors Instinct MMA fans? As you can see, we have an interview coming to you live from last night. Not live, but we did tape it live. But there were some developments with Joe Bagley last night that some of you may or may not be aware of. Actually, I'm not going to go into detail about that. He has to deal with that himself. This was done prior to us knowing of the events that happened last night, the alleged events. We want you to see our interview. We want you to see what Brock has to say now that I spoiled it, but there's nothing to spoil because you already read the title. Thanks for reading, and you know, keep reading us, you know, keep spreading the word about amateur MMA. Now we bring it to our interview. Have a good one. Later. What's up, everybody? Scott from WarriorsInstinctMMA.com. Currently, we're at an undisclosed location, but we have a special guest for you. Obviously, by the title, you're going to read who our special guest is. So we're going to go into a little further and introduce who we have today as our special guest. Next to me, we have Dave Woodby. Next, Dave Brock. Next to Dave, we know Mrs. Brock. So now we know what we're doing here, people. Dave, how you been?
Great.
Excellent. Great seeing you guys again. Glad to be here. I'm excited. You know, I appreciate the exclusive. I'm glad we were able to break the news. Sorry to hear about your health. Glad to hear you're better. Sorry to hear you're about your setback. But I am going to make a statement about your paperwork that we have right here. And I'm going to read it verbatim. I'm going to thank you guys for providing the documentation for your health records, okay? But at this time, I don't care about that. I seen them. If you don't believe me, shut it off right now. Don't look no more. Lucky this man's still here. So we're going to proceed now. Okay? We're going to start off with a couple questions, Dave. And, you know, a lot of fans have been wondering where Dave Brock is. They see, you know, Dave Brock on Facebook now, which was a big surprise. And, you know, giving us some updates and with your health and everything. And it's really good to see. But we're going to hit some hard questions here. Your very first loss came to you.
Yeah.
With Joe Bagley. Let us know your feeling about you wanting to get back into that cage now. What's your feeling of getting back into that cage?
More than anything, because I didn't take him serious, and I had a lot on my mind, and no excuses he got me. But it's definitely made me think, put a different outlook on my fight for me.
Right.
Now I got put my heart and soul in this. I don't want anything more. I don't want anything more out of life than to fight Joe Bagley again.
Excellent.
I don't care what happens in my MMA career, as long as I fight Joe Bagley again. Because I didn't one time, I was ready to fight him up to literally days when I couldn't get medically cleared. And I'm not going to badmouth him, but I don't like him at all. I have a lot of anger issues with him. And because there was a lot of mouth going on when I got sick. Well, for a couple days before that, I tried to fight with my doctors, and I couldn't get medically cleared.
We see that you know, tooth and nail, you fought to get into that cage, and under no circumstances, by not one doctor, by numerous doctors, you were not to get into that cage. I mean, that was a life-threatening situation. Yeah. Like I said, that paperwork's there. I'm glad you showed it to me, but like I said, that's neither here nor there.
Yeah.
But thank you for providing it. So, you have any apprehensions about getting back into the cage at this time?
No, I can't wait.
Can't wait.
Can't wait. I mean, it's the hardest thing was waiting to see if I was going to be able to fight again.
Right.
You know, because that was the big question. Because with the illness that I had was, you know what I mean, it could stop me for good. I had to go see heart specialists and everything. But I got cleared. And it was 50-50 chance. I didn't think I was going to get cleared, but I got cleared.
Good.
And so now I'm excited to get in the cage because for a little bit I was contemplating that it was over with for
right.
me, that I wasn't going to be able to fight again, and that killed me more than anything.
Right.
But the best news I got was like my Christmas present early was when they told me that I can fight again, and I can't wait. I would fight tomorrow, but I don't run my career.
Right.
This man does.
Right. So we'll get into that. You know, like you just said, you were sick for some time.
Yes.
No disrespect, but you're not getting no younger, Brock.
No.
None of us here are getting any younger.
Get back in there.
But do you feel you're going to bounce back as strong as ever?
I think I'm going to be better. I think I'm going to be better because the simple fact is I've lost. You know what I mean? And it humbled me.
You felt that defeat.
And it humbled me.
You know that.
It made me hungry. I wasn't hungry. You know what I mean? I'm right. Hungry now.
Right.
I'm starving.
Starving. Got to get back in there.
Oh, I can't wait.
Excellent. Now, we know you have, you said that, you know, you feel it personal with Bagley because of what he spoke. Do you think you owe it to your fans, too, to get back into that cage? Was that one of your driving forces? I see a lot of your posts.
I think I owe it to my fans. I owe it to my fans because I wasn't 100% that day. I had a lot of stuff mentally on my mind, but I'm not going to make no excuses. But if you look at my previous fights and you look at that fight, you can see a lot of stuff different.
Right. We could see your face different.
Face different, yeah. You know what I mean? Without getting into stuff, you can see a lot of stuff. But the thing is I owe it to my fans. There's a lot of people that came out there and paid to watch me, and a lot of people that believe in me, and I didn't give them 100% that day. And that's the worst, that's the one fight that I'm going to regret for the rest of my life, because I can't take that back, because I owe it to my fans. They're the ones that are my driving force. It keeps me training hard and hard, and one loss is not a big deal to some people, but that was the end of the world for me. Right. I left that cage, and I ran out. I went home. I went home, and I still had my wraps on. I still had all my clothes on. That was devastating for me.
Sure.
And I owe it, and not just me, it was devastating that I let down everybody that was behind me. Right. And I'll never do that again.
Never.
And if somebody beats me, I'm humbled enough that, you know, they beat me. You
right.
know what I mean? On my best day, they beat me. And I give 100%. I don't take that from him. He won.
Right.
He should have just won and kept his mouth shut and took it like that. You know what I mean? Like sure. I said, at best, he's a one-hit wonder.
Right. Now, we're talking about your age and stuff. Now, I'm not going to get into the particulars because Dave has already told me, you know, you guys are working on a lot of different things. So we're not going to ask you the particulars. And maybe you still won't answer this. What is it going to be, stand up or ground? What do you think? No comment right now, huh?
No comment.
I'm like in trouble. I tried to get over on Dave.
I will tell you this. You're going to see a different Brock. You're going to see a wholly different Brock. I will tell you that. You're not going to see
a whole different game.
A whole different game plan. You're going to see a whole different Brock, a whole different fighter.
Excellent.
Mentally, physically, I've never had nothing drive me. This has been like, I've never been so focused on something in my life.
Excellent.
Than after. In a way, Joe did me a favor.
Right.
You know, because he made me a smarter, stronger fighter. And then when I got faced with this medical issue, that sidelined me right after a loss, right before a rematch, made me look like a coward.
Right.
And they fed into that, and it's like kicking a man when he's down. And the thing is I'm not that person.
Right.
You know what I mean?
Well, we had spoke with Dave. We had contacted Dave when you didn't show to make sure you were okay. I had a concern. Once again, we didn't publicize that or nothing. A couple of people did ask us, and we did tell him that we spoke with Dave, and he said, Scott, I'm telling you the truth. I don't have the paperwork now, but Dave could not be here. So anybody that calls you a coward, well, that's the farthest from your truth.
Yeah.
When a man's sick.
Yeah, it doesn't matter. That's here nor there. I'm going to show them. It doesn't matter. I'm going to show them.
You still got to fight.
The next, At the end of the day, when the cage door shuts and it's just me and him,
all right, so now we're talking about Joe Bagley. What promotion are you going to fight for next?
We got to go where he is.
Okay. So you're chasing.
We have to.
Listen, I want my heavyweight title back. That's my goal, is to get my Cage Wars heavyweight title. I'm going to get that back. I'm going to chase him wherever he wants to go. He's first priority, then that. If he's in a lower weight class, then we'll fight a lower weight class.
Well, that's what we're going to tell you, because if you follow Joe is going down to light heavyweight.
That's
he's
okay.
training now
that's
for fine. That belt. You're a big boy. I mean, that's a lot of muscle.
But,
I mean,
but fight time, we always weigh in between 215 and 217.
Right.
And that's really not turning up the heat to drop the weight. So at 215, a week out, we'll be at 205 if we need to be. It doesn't matter. You can run, but you can't hide.
And I could dehydrate myself and rehydrate myself in one day. I'm only 5. Realistically, I'm happy, but I'm more muscle, and I'm only 5'8".
Right.
So because of my frame, I can get down to 205 and then rehydrate back up to 220 the next day.
Sure.
I mean, it doesn't matter day of the fight. That's why we fight the day before. That's why we measure.
It doesn't matter what weight he wants.
Yeah, it doesn't matter.
It's coming.
He's first in demi title.
So no matter what weight class,
we're going to. I don't care if we go to lightweight.
The South Troy Warriors bringing that belt back
bringing
to South
belt,
Troy.
Yes.
No matter what belt.
Whatever. If he goes to another weight class, he's got that belt. I'll take that too.
Right. So you don't want
heavyweight? For the rest of my career, I want heavyweight. I like heavyweight division.
Right.
But if he's running the 205, and that's running to 205, we're going to go to 205. We'll go wherever he goes. Wherever he goes.
I don't care if he goes lightweight.
It doesn't matter where he is. You want to go 185, we'll go 185.
Right.
You know? All it is discipline. All it is where you're going to be at and what we need to do to get there, and that's it. And I don't even know if he's going to make it there. I don't know if he, I personally feel, and you guys can say whatever you want, I don't think you have the discipline to get to 205. But surprise me. But if he does, he gets to 205, we'll be there waiting for him.
Nice.
But I don't think he's got the resolve to do that. Hey, that's how I feel.
So, you know, we're going to back up to your fight now, okay? And we just talked about how, you know, it's not the Brock we know that stepped into the cage that
night.
I was going
through a lot of personal issues.
Yeah.
I mean, I just had, if you noticed, I had half of my body tattooed over.
Right.
I mean, that was literally, I don't know, excuses, he beat me.
Right.
But I mean, I went in there with 2-day-old tattoos, and it wasn't just one tattoo, I had half of my body recovered over.
Right.
I mean, anybody can look at the fight before that and then look at all the tattoo work I had.
Sure.
You know what I mean? There was a lot of personal things I was going through. It was a lot on my plate.
Yeah.
Well, I got nothing on my plate but him this time.
Gotcha.
So.
Gotcha. We went into, you know, where you had underestimated Bagley.
And that was my big
time.
Mistake.
And that was your biggest mistake that night. You know, you had some things going on.
I already was looking past him, and I guess he showed me.
And he showed you. So. Dave Brock is back.
Oh, yeah.
When's Dave Brock going to start training?
Oh, he's already been training.
Dave Brock's already
started. Started Monday. Actually, when you leave, we'll be training. I'm going to train every day. Like I said, I can't say when I'm going to fight because he does that.
Right.
He controls my career. I'm just a fighter, and I can't, you know what I mean? Me and him have our arguments, but at the end of the day, he makes the final
decision.
No matter how much I'm arguing, yell to him, blow him in the face, it doesn't matter. He makes the final decision, I don't.
So Dave, I don't know if I asked this, what are we looking at?
February
we're looking at. Yeah. February. And what's going to happen to Dave in that time?
A lot.
Just the whole transformation?
Yeah, he probably is not going to like me.
No?
Yeah.
Not going to be
you
good?
Don't like me now?
Yeah.
No. It's not going to be good. So,
yeah,
you know, here we are with Team Brock, Hoodlum. You know, I'm very humbled by you guys. We've been asked to always do a lot of interviews. You gave us the exclusive. We appreciate that. We wanted the fans to know, you know, once again, we're somewhere where, you know, we like to be, and this is where it is. We are biased, believe it or not, and people will say we're not because here we are with Team Brock, but... as a lot of people know, Team Brock is part of my family as well.
And
I have no denying that at any time. They're part of my family.
I think I speak for us, all of us, our whole team, everybody that's involved, that you've always been stand up with us.
We have a lot of love
always.
For you guys.
We have a lot of love.
And that's what you guys been with us. You know, we've never had no, you know, when things have come down the pike, I think everybody's been truthful with us. You know, just supplying us with what you did, getting a hold of us again. I want to take all that people think the credibility factor out of, you know, oh, well, he didn't have a signed doctor note. Well, who in the right mind is going to put a signed doctor note online? We know that can't happen. You know, let's face it. I'm glad you're back. We're glad you're back. The fans are glad you're back, Brock. Let us know. We're going to stay in touch. We're going to keep this one short. Obviously, because we're not going to get much out of you as training-wise. We're not getting much out of your stand-up. We're not getting much out of your ground. We don't know.
I see him looking at me.
That's why I'm trying to look at him. I'm hoping he's going to break a little.
I will tell you this. It's a lot of this training camp is really I'm really excited because we're doing a lot of different things.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm really excited. It's this training camp is totally different than anything I've ever done.
Right.
I will tell you, I'm going to be more athletic in there. Okay. Because I'm a very athletic person, and I've been, and if you notice my fights, I really haven't been showing that because you just see me coming in knocking people out.
Right.
Well, I'm going to show that I'm an athlete.
Right.
And I am very athletic, and I'm going to start using that to my advantage because there's a lot of guys that, you know what I mean, that just go through the moves. Right. I don't go through the moves. So, you know what I mean, I got to be more, this is going to make me more disciplined and a way better fighter than I've ever been.
Right.
And mentally, it's already tough as nails.
Yeah, yeah.
This guy's like you said, he's the hardest trainer. I've worked with a lot of trainers over the years. He's definitely by far the hardest I've ever did, and we're best friends.
Right.
But when we come down here, we're not best friends. And I hate him from the moment. I tell you, I hate him from the moment we start to the moment he's sitting the fuck on me.
Right.
And I can't breathe, and he's trying to drop his forearm in my face.
Sure.
You know?
All part of it, huh?
Oh, yeah.
Just getting it in there.
A lot of love with us.
A lot of love.
A lot of love.
Is that what it is?
Love-hate relationship.
It's a love-hate
relationship.
Excellent.
But I do want to say, when I get a chance, that I, you know what I mean? I do this mostly for the fans. I really appreciate when I get stuff. I really, really, the fans will motivate me. Because when I didn't know if I was going to fight again, didn't know if I was going to be able to fight, that was devastating. But the fans, you know what I mean, through all the bad stuff that happened and all the controversy, most of my fans still stuck by me on my Facebook.
Right.
I didn't go on my Facebook because I was having a lot of mixed emotions, so I stayed away from my Facebook. I just started going back on it, just giving thoughts, just feelings come through me, and I'll write it down.
Good.
But, you know what I mean, them guys, a lot of my fans, you know what I mean, always asked about me, always stuck by me. You know what I mean? Said stuff to me that meant something. Like, your son, he wrote something to me, and that really, like, touched me. And
yeah.
And it was stuff like that that makes me...
We had a lot of stuff that was written.
That really got to me, man. I kept
yeah.
that. That really... Because that was important for me, and it meant something. Because, and that's, you know what I mean? I can't lose
right.
with that feeling going in the cage.
Sure.
Because it ain't just about me. I'm feeding off all the people that believe in me.
I mean, you've seen, you know, a lot of people start putting your YouTube video, well, not your YouTube video, but your Warriors Ball. And the fans were calling for you for a while, if I'm right. I mean, I've seen a lot of that on there. I've seen that YouTube video on there. They were calling. They were calling
well,
for
I'm
the
here.
Warrior to get back
I'm
out
here.
There, right?
I'm here,
and
I'm
Warriors
not leaving
coming.
Again. I'm here, I'm fully healthy, I got a clean bill of health.
Excellent.
And like you said, we're training like a madman, and I'm here, and I'm not going anywhere.
Great.
You know, I hope to have a long career around here. Before I venture on to bigger and better things. You know what I mean? After February, after we get this out of the way, I want to fight on a regular basis. I have a lot of, I want to fight a lot, you know. I have a lot of, anger issues I got to vent out.
Yeah, controlled chaos in there.
Yes.
Yes.
But outside here, I'm a nice guy.
Yeah, nicest guy. We know you outside the
cage. And you guys are like family.
Yeah.
And I'm never doing an interview without you. You guys would be the ones we do the
interview. We appreciate it. And like I said,
I had people contact us, but this is the thing, is I have to feel comfortable. I feel like we're family.
Right, exactly.
I can trust you 100%. And that's why you'll never see me in front of a camera talking to somebody else.
We appreciate that.
Unless it's ESPN
right.
or HBO.
Yeah. Well, you never know. Hopefully we'll get on one of those gigs one day. You know, we might be announcing for ESPN or something, but I don't know. Okay, we won't. But listen, we'll be there behind you, you know, right by your side. We want to thank you for your time. I know you got to get training, and Dave has to do a little magic down here. And,
yeah.
You know, we probably want to leave, get down the road before the screams ensue. I want to thank you. I want to thank everybody for showing. I want to thank everybody for watching this video. Anybody has any questions, any questions, any credibility that was here tonight, please email me. If you want to email me your hate mail and all that other stuff, again, I deal with it. I don't care. I've been through it. I've been threatened by bigger people. It don't matter to me. It don't matter. We're here for you guys. I'm glad to see you back. We're here for Amateur MMA. That's what we're here for. You're part of Amateur MMA. We're going to make it grow. We're going to make it strong. We can't wait to see you back.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, and thank your family.
Thank you. Thank you, Brock. I'm glad.